What's up, guys? Just got back from Japan. I was out there for a whole month. The training was awesome. I apologize for not uploading some of the videos I said I was going to upload, but now we're here today to bring you Armbars from Marcelo Garcia. I hope you guys like it. Here's Mariah. She looks pretty happy. Happier than the last time. I don't know what else to say.
I think we'll edit all of that out.
First time I saw Marcelo Garcia finish an armbar, it was in a 2006 Brasileiro tape. It's pretty rare to find because most of the time he's on the back attacking, but whenever he does finish an armbar, it's generally the same sequence he goes through to break the arms apart, and that's what we're going to go over here. What I think is really important about the sequence is not just the method of doing it, but when we ask the questions of why it works, it helps us understand attacking our opponent as a whole. Now, most people, when they try to finish the armbar, they hook through and they use the crux of their elbow to pull back on the crux of the other person's elbow. The reason for doing this is naturally, this is a comfortable spot to use. This is a very strong area of our body, and it's got a nice little comfortable angle for us. The problem being, we're using the same comfortable spot on their body to attack. So even though it's strong for me, it's strong for her as well. This is counterproductive. We want better jiu-jitsu than that. We need to go down and attack the wrist where the body's weak. The problem is, if our hand goes down and attacks wrist to wrist, we're just using the same weak part of our body. So we have to adjust our positioning and attack with the crux of our elbow all the way forward onto her wrist. If I'm pulling with just my arms, I'm still using bad jiu-jitsu. But if I pull with my chest here, body tight, this is good jiu-jitsu. Now we gotta combine that with some tight knees, pinching our knees tight together for better pressure, and pulling our heels in, which engages our tailbone and our crotch for more power. So tight knees together, pulling our heels in, and then hooking nice and high, elbow over her wrist, and going back. Now, even if she resists, it should be very hard for me not to break this arm. This is a very good solution to the problem, but there is still one more underlying issue. There's not much of a ledge for our arm to catch. It's very easy for the arm to slide back down. Let's see if I can give you guys a better angle. Because there's not much ledge here, even if I'm sitting forward, the arm can easily slip right back down to that comfortable spot of her elbow. And then we're fighting strength versus strength instead of strength versus weakness. We need to change the angle of our body so that we can keep better friction on this wrist. So where am I going to take her? I'm going to take her straight up where I still have the same power, but she loses even more of hers. And I get a lot better friction, a lot better grip. Here's what it looks like, guys. When I fall towards her head, I have so much more power here because I'm still engaging my chest, my elbow, all the strong parts of my knees and my body while attacking the weakest part of her arm. And this is a very powerful position, and I get to maintain the friction that I didn't have previously when I was up here. Because now, instead of going sliding down in a bad direction, I have a nice perpendicular cross. And that gives me a lot of friction this direction. So after I break this grip, I can't finish over here. Not only is it harder for me to get leverage on her elbow, but it's very close for her to being able to hitchhike or escape. Like so. So I have to square back up to finish. Now, in order for this submission to be foolproof, we have to touch on a couple other details. Then we'll be ready to go. The first one being, doesn't matter the orientation of her hands, whether they're grasped together here, 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 grabbing her own collar, the submission works the same way. No matter where the hands are, if we hook underneath and we find the soft spot of her wrist, it doesn't really matter where it's resting. Even if it's grabbing her own collar, we just hook through and find the wrist with our elbow and pull it tight to our chest. Should get the same job done. Secondly, we always use the head side hand, and the main reason being, her body is much stronger down here. We can still lift a good amount of pressure when our arms are down towards our hips, but when our hands are up high over our head, they get very weak. Can you imagine trying to do like a bench press up here? It'd be much harder than here or here. That's why we prefer to fall towards the head then to fall towards the feet. And in order to do that, we need to hook with the head side hand. So, if you're ever confused, the leg side hand is going to be hooking here, and the head side hand comes in, and we hook. The only other detail I'd like to mention is that going straight back is good and powerful, but sometimes it's just not enough leverage to break the guy's arm. And Marcelo has mentioned he tends to lean towards this inside hip and pull right into the corner of where our crotch meets our thigh. Part of the reason this makes it so much more powerful to finish an armbar is because we have a little more leverage when we go to the side. It gives us a little power. This joint in here is very strong, as opposed to pulling right inside of our crotch here, where, man, things are soft and we have to pinch our knees really tight, but it's powerful, it's just not as powerful. Whereas when we pull into our little joint measurement here, everything is compact, there's like a nice powerful bone in there, and on top of that, it gives us this ledge so that we can pull down past our arm and get a lot more pressure here for a break. So it's something for you guys to try. Instead of pulling straight down into my crotch, I'm gonna rotate the thumb about 15 degrees, and I'm gonna pull her elbow down into this joint right here. When I do this, I can go this far, and then I can push the arm into this empty space, this void over here. That's about another 12 inches. I mean, I'd never like to do that, but that would really mangle somebody's arm. It'd fuck it up. Fuck it up really good. Anyways, those are my details on Marcelo Garcia's version of finishing the armbar. Let me know what you guys think. Great fighting videos coming up soon. Thank you very much. See you next time.
Attracted to things that'll bring the trauma. Overseas, yeah, we trying to stop terrorism, but we still got terrorists here living in the USA, the big CIA, the Bloods and the Crips and the KKK. But if you only have love for your own race, then you only leave space to discriminate, and to discriminate only generates hate, and when you hate, then you're bound to get irate. Yeah, madness is what you demonstrate, and that's exactly how anger works and operates. Man, you gotta have love just to set it straight. Take control of your mind and meditate. Let your soul gravitate to the love, y'all.
People
y'all.
Killing, people dying, children hurt and you hear them crying. Can you practice what you preach, and would you turn the other cheek?